Hi everybody, how are you doing? Welcome to this video. Today I wanted to talk about Aesop, this brand, and give you my honest review of their product. The brand is very aesthetically pleasing with their packaging as well as the design of their stores. I've tried some of their products and some of them I like and some of them I don't really like. So in today's video, I'll give my honest review of some of their popular products. So if you wanted to know whether the content itself is as good as the exterior, let's find out in this video. So let's get started. My name is Gladys Lee. I created this channel to share my honest review on different skincare products and how you can perfect your skincare routine. Feel free to subscribe to my channel and turn on that notification bell so you don't miss any of my new videos. Aesop has a range of products ranging from skincare products to body products. I have picked some of their popular products in their skincare line and I'll go through them one by one. If you want me to review any of their body products, you can leave a comment down below. If I have enough requests, I'll make one for their body products. The first one is the Parsley Seed Facial Cleanser. Let's have a look of what they included into this cleanser. The cleansing agent that they use in this cleanser is with sodium lauryl sulfate. With this ingredients, it's actually a very strong cleansing agent and it would be a problematic for people who have sensitive skin. I would say that having this sodium lauryl sulfate might be a little drying for my skin. I can see that they have added olive oil, lavender oil, lactic acid, glycerin, jojoba seed oil. They have licorice root extract and they have obviously, you know, parsley seed oil. And then at the end, they added fragrance lavender oil. I'm going to reference to a chemist here on YouTube, Kenna. She talked a little bit about essential oil within skincare products. The essential oil itself doesn't have any problem or issue with it, unless you are fundamentally allergic to essential oils. Essential oils like lavender oil or any kind of citrus essential oils, they can oxidize pretty quickly. The byproduct after these essential oil oxidized are very sensitizing for your skin. Say for example, you could be using this product for half a year and these essential oils started to break down and the byproduct itself is very, very sensitizing and you eventually develop sensitivity around this product or rashes on your face. So lactic acid could possibly help with mildly exfoliate your skin and also has glycerin, jojoba oil. They have a bunch of oil that helps to maintain the moisture on your skin. Licorice root extract. Licorice root extract could help to calm down the redness on your skin. However, at the end, they have added two fragrances. These two fragrances are known allergens in the market. In the EU, they actually need to list out these ingredients in their bottle and say that they have added these ingredients into the products. There are a lot of other cleansers that are fragrance free and do its job of cleansing your face, unless you're addicted to the scent itself or you love this brand so much that you wouldn't mind. Otherwise, I really don't see why you wanted to use this cleanser, because there are other cleansers that are great doing its job in the market. I would not recommend this. I personally would not purchase this. Let's move on to the Chamomile Concentrate Anti-Blemish Mask. This mask, as they label it, is anti-blemish. When I look at the ingredient list, I was kind of like have mixed feelings. What's good about this mask is that it has kaolin, bentonite clay, it has glycerin, moisturizing agent, it has lemon oil peel, they have rose oil, rosemary oil, it also has tea tree leaf oil, it has sage oil as well. It has a bunch of hydrating ingredients in this mask. If you don't already know, kaolin and bentonite is a mask that helps to get rid of the oil on your face. They have also added this oil so that it would not be too drying on your skin. It also contains tea tree oil to have the anti-inflammatory properties. However, the fourth ingredient is denatured alcohol. And then they have also added two fragrances in this product. I know not a lot of people are allergic to fragrances. However, when you have acne, your skin is inflamed. Adding fragrances is one thing. Adding denatured alcohol as a fourth ingredient in this mask for people who are already inflamed with their acne, it just doesn't make any sense. Like, it's so confusing. Like, the formulation itself, it has the good ingredients that could help to anti-inflame the acne on your skin. However, it added ingredients that could also inflame your skin. If I have blemishes, I will not use this mask. Let's put it that way, okay? So that's my opinion. Then let's go into the Parsley Seed Antioxidant Facial Treatment. This is actually a facial oil that they have put together, but they name it as facial treatment. If you have not checked out my other video on skincare products that you don't really need, I've talked about facial oil as something that is not really necessary, because the occlusivity that you want can be found in a very good moisturizer. So what makes a good moisturizer would be they have humectant, emollient, and also have occlusive. It moisturizes your skin as well as it creates a film or protective layer to prevent any transepidermal water loss. So unless you live in a very dry environment or your skin is extremely dehydrated, this could be a nice to have extra step you can add to your skincare routine. With this facial treatment, mainly it contains a lot of plant oil. It also added lavender oil. Lavender oil talked about in the Definitely. Previous cleanser, I would stay away from it. It also contains obviously parsley seed oil. With all this plant oil, it's already smelling great. They needed to add two more fragrances into this facial oil. I would say that there are other facial oil that is without the additional fragrances, because all this plant oil already has its own fragrances. For me, this facial oil is like, it's nice to have, you know, it's not necessary. If you have an extra buck, you can spend it on the facial oil, but I personally don't think that you need it unless you have really, 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 really dry skin or you live in a very, 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 very dry environment. That's my opinion. So the next one is the BCCC Facial Balancing Gel. This product is quite popular within their skincare brand. I saw people's comment on this product. People claim that they can see their skin appears to be brighter after using this, and it could help to get rid of some of the blemishes on their skin. Looking at the ingredients, it contains the magnesium ascorbate phosphate. It's quite high up in the ingredient list. It is the fifth ingredient. And it also has witch hazel water, has a bit of lactic acid, and obviously it has the parsley seed oil. The magnesium ascorbate phosphate, I don't know if I read it correctly, just bear with me. This ingredient is a water-soluble vitamin C derivative. You can actually find this ingredient in the ordinary product line as well. When I search more about this ingredient, I can see there are studies. However, the evidence is not like a concrete, it must help your skin in da-da-da-da-da certain way. What it suggested is that it could or may help to anti-inflame your skin and also give you a bit of the antioxidant effect. If you wanted to have antioxidant or vitamin C, there are loads of other products that are available in the market that has the active form of vitamin C, that has tons of research on how effective they are in brightening our skin and fading pigmentation and also giving us the antioxidant effect, anti-inflammatory effect, such as the SkinCeuticals C ferulic acid or even Timeless. There are lots of products out there in the market that has the active form instead of the derivatives. For this derivatives, it would take time for it to convert to its active form on your skin. So in other words, some people would say that slow release. And also it contains lavender oil. As I said, lavender oil itself is, I don't have an issue with that. It's just that when it oxidizes, it would produce byproducts, and those byproducts are very, very sensitizing for your skin. So I would stay away from it. If you have blemishes or any kind of sensitivity around your face, I would stay away from it. And also, obviously, they have added fragrances in this product. Obviously, everything in Aesop are fragranced. These are the known allergen fragrances. If you are someone who have really sensitive, you know, acne-prone skin, I would not go for any products within this brand, because this product line or this brand, most of their stuff are very heavily fragranced. They either have essential oil or they have added fragrance in it. Essential oils and fragrances are known allergen for your face. If you have acne-prone skin or you have sensitive skin, I would suggest that you stay away from this brand. The main reason being, acne is a type of inflammation. For people who have sensitive skin, your skin would get triggered quite easily. All these added fragrances or essential oil could potentially irritate your skin. I know it's aesthetically very pleasing, smells great in their stores, and most of the product smells great. However, when you use it on your body or on your face, these fragrances might not be your best friend. However, if you're not allergic to essential oils or fragrances, I would give this brand a try, because some of the products really smells amazing. But if you love the scent itself, if you enjoy the products, feel free to let me know what they do on your skin. Thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed what I've shared today, feel free to give this video a thumbs up. Share this with your friends who are looking into buying Aesop or interested in this brand. I have more videos on different product reviews and how you can take care of your skin. You can check them out at the end of this video. I will see you in my next one. Bye!